Hello friends, my name is Gunjan and you are watching Glamour Unleashed. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very requested video. I know I was a beginner once and now many of you are beginners who are learning the art of makeup, but you guys don't know where to start, what to buy, what not to buy. So I've got a few things listed down and I'll show you like what are the things that you can buy, what are the things that you should keep in mind while buying these things. So it's quite informative, so keep watching if you want to know. So as you can see, I have my makeup beginner's kit with me. So it has all the things that I needed during first stage of my learning in the art of makeup. I'm still learning, you guys. I do not say that I'm an expert or a professional. I'm still learning, but I think I have learned a bit and I have many things to learn, so it's okay. And people will judge you no matter what, so just keep it this way, don't do it. So the first product that I have for you, obviously the most important thing in makeup is your base. Like, you need something to smoothen out your face. Obviously, after washing your face, after toning your face and moisturizing your face, the first thing that you need on your face is a very good primer. Now I know many of you must be thinking, oh, primer, it would be expensive. No guys, it's really not necessary that it would be expensive. You have many options. You can go for the high end, but if you are a beginner, you should stick to the basic things and try what's working for you. Okay, so the first thing that I have for you for as your base, so a disclaimer before I start this video, my skin is oily and combination type, oily to combination type, so I would be suggesting the products regarding keeping in mind that. So please don't judge me guys that, oh, she said that, oh, she said that. Okay, so please don't do that to me. Okay, so I have oily to combination skin, and the things that I used for my skin, oily to combination skin, are, and which worked for me, are shown in the video. Okay, so I'm starting with the video. The first thing I used as my primer was this lactocalamine. Let me tell you, it has many nice benefits. It smoothens out your skin. It is a bit tinted, so it does give you a very little minor kind of coverage, and it just smoothens your face. It makes it like a smooth canvas, so it's really nice. It's for oily skin, and yeah, lactocalamine does come for dry skin type too. So if you wanna check it out, you can definitely check it out, guys. The next option that I want to give you guys as a primer is this Patanjali aloe vera gel, guys. Now you can use any kind of aloe vera gel that you have with you, but remember guys, just use a very tiny amount or else you would be just making your face a mess and your makeup wouldn't be sticking to it. It's really nice, but you should know how much to use. Guys, my suggestion would be try a very bit. Start with a very little amount, and then gradually, if you need, then you can take a little bit more. Okay guys, so I think this is done for the primer thing. Now coming to the foundation part. Now many guys do foundation first, many guys do guys I can say people do concealer first, but look, I'm showing in the way that I'm grabbing my things, so it's nothing like in the order. Okay, so because I do foundation first, I would say about foundation only. So the next thing that I have for you is this foundation. It's from Maybelline Dream Satin Skin. This is really nice, but guys, this has SPF. Okay, so if you are trying for the if you're wearing this and go clicking photos, then I don't think this is a good option. Okay, but you can try the foundations that do not have SPF for clicking photos. That would be that would come more better. So the one I used in my beginning days was this green satin skin. It was really nice. It's really nice to blend. It is inexpensive. It comes at the cost of ₹700. Like, I know it may be expensive for some, but see the quantity that it comes, and I think you'll make a good use of this. This comes in this hygienic pack pump kind of thing. So I think it's really nice. It's really nice to use and easy to use. You do not need a separate brush or a sponge to blend it. You can blend it with your hands, and it's really easy to use. So the next thing that I want to show you guys is the concealer. The concealer that I use for myself is this, again, from Maybelline. It's the Dream Lumi Touch concealer. This is really nice, especially for your under eyes, guys. I do not have scars or something. So if you have some scars, you can use a concealer exactly similar to your skin. But if you just want to highlight your skin, so you can use a shade or two lighter to your skin type. Okay, so I do not have any scars on my face, so I don't have a concealer exactly matching to my skin. Yeah, but I do use a concealer for my highlighting purpose, and for that highlighting purpose, this is my go-to thing. I really like it, and this is almost finished. I will be going and purchasing a new one. It's really nice, guys. It's really nice. I think you should try this. Next thing that I have to set all your makeup, foundation and concealer in place is a good compact. So the compact that is really budget friendly and really nice and for oily skin type is this L'Oreal Matte Magique. Now this is really amazing, you guys. This is my favorite. You'll find it everywhere. Like, I never step out of the house without this. It's really nice. It keeps my all in control. It gives us medium coverage also, and it's really good to use. The only the one thing that I hate about this is the it opens like this way, and then again here is the mirror. And please forgive me, guys, for the dirty sponge. Can't help it. I use it every day. Okay, but this is really nice, compact, and I think you should give a try. It costs, I think, 300 rupees or 400 rupees. I don't remember, you guys, but you should definitely check it. It's really, really nice. Now, coming to blush and contouring and highlighting. In the beginning stage, I don't think you guys can afford, like anybody can afford. If they can afford, it's really nice. You can buy it separately. But I thought that it's my beginning stage. Why should I spend so much on single products? Rather, I should buy a palette and I'm good to go. So I bought this LA Girls Glow palette. It's a blush bronzer highlighter palette, and it's really nice. It's the blush collection. It has two blushes and one contouring shade and one highlighter shade, and it's really nice, guys. I think in the beginning stage, you should not go for buying separate things, rather go for palettes. They would be time saving, money saving, and whatnot. And you guys will get a hold of brush or your finger or whatever technique you're using to apply your makeup. So I think it's really great, okay? Again, now coming to eye makeup. Now again, as I said, palettes are really helpful. So guys, always go for palettes when you are going when you are a beginner, and gradually when you have your hands set, then you can obviously go for the singles. So the palette I would be suggesting is from Makeup Revolution. It's the Redemption palette, Essential Day to Night. This is a very good palette. This brand is really nice. They have many shades. So go out there, check out there. Whatever you need, go buy that and see how it fares on you. Okay. Now, coming to mascara. Now, Maybelline has really, really affordable products. And I think Maybelline was the one. Maybelline was one such brand that I was trying every product. Because it was really affordable, guys. You don't find so expensive things there. and they're really easy to use. So I really like the brand, and they have never disappointed me. Yeah, I do have one or two miss, but generally they are hit. So, and this is the Colossal Volume Mascara. I have been using it like even before kajal and lipstick were my staples. After kajal and lipstick became my staple, this came, and one of my friends introduced me to it, like you should try mascara, wearing mascara, it like awakens your eyes and whatnot, she sent me, and I said okay, let me try it. And once I tried, I could not go back. Like I really love this. It's like third or fourth tube of mine, and I always like love this mascara. So I'm really happy that I have mascara with me all the time. Like now it's a staple. Now coming again for the eyeliner purpose, guys. When you are in your beginning stage, you need to have a eyeliner that is really budget friendly and which does the work too. So I have this Lakme Insta liner with me. It comes around 100-150 and it's really nice. Brush is really pointed, so you guys can make a really, as you can see, it's really really nice. The brush is really nice. It's not very thin, guys, but it's okay. I'll say okay. It's okay for your beginning purpose, and when you get a hand on your eyelining skills, then I think you can go for more hi-fi things like sketch liner and eyeliner kind of things, and I think they are good. So before that, for beginners, I think this Lakme Insta liner is a really nice pick because it doesn't cost much. The next thing I want you guys to know is about kajals. Now kajals are one thing that are really personal and specific that you can buy on your own needs and what is available near you. Like I do have faces kajal, and which is about to finish. Then I do have with me MAC Kohl pencil and Lakme Iconic and many more. You know, I'm a kajal holder. Now we are done with eye makeup also. So what's left? Now lips are left. So for lips, I think you have many options. You can go for many things. So the lip options that I have for you is this Maybelline. First thing is this Faces Lip Contour Pencils. Now these are really affordable, and they cost 200 or 300 in between, and these are really necessary because when you are in the beginning stage, you need to know how to line your lips and then fill in, because I think straight away using a lipstick would make it a messy thing. I don't prefer it, so I would suggest you guys to use a lip pencil because it would make your process a lot smoother. Now coming to lipsticks, I do have three options for you. Like the first one is this Kate Moss lipstick. Now Kate Moss range is in the Rimmel London Kate Moss. Like this is really really affordable range. This cost I think 275 rupees. Yes, 275 rupees. So I don't think, and it's really pigmented, you guys. I should say you, Kate Moss lipsticks are really pigmented. You should give it a try. It's really amazing. I love them. And this is the shade that I have. It's a really bright fuchsia pink. I love it. Love it to bits. In winters, I use just this. I don't know why, but I'm hooked to this. Then this Lakme 925 range. This is again 400 or 500. And this is again affordable. This rose gold color makes it oh so attractive. I can't say. I love this. I love anything that's rose gold. You know me. I love rose gold. I don't know what is with this. Now this is a perfect nude shade. Guys, you have many things, many lipstick brands are there that you can go explore whatever you like, you feel like. Go explore it, whatever it is, 200, 300. There are many lipsticks that they have, like Lakme has, Maybelline has, Rimmel has. I'm sure many other would have. So you should go and try those. Like Maybelline have this lip, what do they call? I don't know what are they called. Velvet matte, I think. So even these are really nice. These are in the shape of a lipstick, but they are like liquid lipstick. So in the range of 400 or 500, I don't think these are bad. Like, I really like it. They are really easy to use. So I guess I have covered all. Lipsticks are there, bullet lipsticks are there, then liquid lipsticks are there. You have it in the range. 300, 400, 500, there is everything for everybody. So guys, I think this is everything. Oh, sorry, I forgot one thing. Makeup is done, but what about after makeup? So after makeup, guys, never, never your makeup kit is complete without a makeup remover. Makeup remover is a must. Guys, never sleep with your makeup on. It will age your skin like anything. And it's a crime. It's a sin. It's a sin. Seriously, guys, it's a sin. So never sleep with your makeup on. Always remove it. The best budget option I can give you is this Maybelline New York Clean Express Makeup Remover. It's really good. You can also go with your good old coconut oil. Just dab it on the cotton wool and just remove your makeup and you're good to go. And coconut oil has many benefits, like it's really good for your skin. So either a makeup remover or coconut oil, whatever is handy, guys, do remember, do remove your makeup and then sleep. And sleep your beauty sleep. So yeah guys, I think it's all for today. This is all you should have in your makeup kit. So guys, if you liked my video, then do give it a thumbs up and do subscribe my channel below. The subscribe button is in the red color. Do subscribe to my channel. And yeah, I'll leave to the links to all of the products that I have shown now. You can directly click on the link and purchase the product. And so see you soon. Bye bye.